In the next 15 minutes, I want to talk about remote sensing and how remote sensing can be used for urban research at scale and for understanding urbanization processes. Specifically, I will show how we have been using Google Earth Engine as a platform for planetary scale analysis. In one case study into the detection of urban areas in India. So as you all know, urbanization is one of the most fundamental trends of the past two centuries. In the last 60, 70 years, the share of the urban population increased from 30 to 54%, and it is expected to reach up to 66% by 2050, primarily in Asia and Africa. And urbanization is, of course, closely related to many aspects of the modern world, whether it's economic development and economic opportunity, social change, food security, biodiversity, ecologies. However, the rate and the magnitude of urbanization have not yet been quantified in global scales, and for many low-income countries, the last significant mapping occurred in the 1960s and 70s. There are different ways to measure urbanization, survey-based population counts, administrative data, social media, cell phone records, nighttime light, and of course, satellite imagery. And indeed, in the last decade, we see more and more satellite imagery available at ever-improving spatial and temporal resolutions, together with the development of different machine learning approaches that are designed to capture the unique characteristics of urban land. There are many, many satellites currently that orbit Earth and continuously collect data at different spatial and spectral and temporal resolutions. And we saw throughout the day that this data can be used for many research projects. However, until recently, the majority of the remote sensing research have been done at the local scale, at the scale of a city or the surrounding of the city. We want, this is partially because of computational limitations. But we want to map the world. We want to understand the world. So we are working with big data. So we need to rethink about the methodology and the capacity that will be used to map and understand the world. Instead of counting individual trees, we want to map ecosystems in global scales. Instead of detecting individual cities or individual infrastructures in the city, we want to map the entire urban land. So luckily, in the past few years, we see more and more cloud-based computational platforms that allow you to scale up the analysis both across space and time. One of them is DGBX, which belongs to Digital Globe, which will, Shai will also say a few words on it. And another one is Google Earth Engine, which we have been using. Earth Engine is a cloud-based computational platform designed for planetary scale analysis. It consists of petabytes of geospatial and tabular data, both raster and vector, and they also allow you to upload your own raster data and do the analysis on their platform using their algorithms and servers. It has a very convenient JavaScript and Python-based API with many algorithms for supervised and unsupervised machine learning, and the advantage is that they also store the full catalog of Landsat, Sentinel-2, MODIS, and existing classification products that were created by different research groups, for example, WorldPop or Matt Hansen's deforestation data. And we've been using UCSD Google Earth Engine for different projects, and we developed a remote sensing course that also emphasizes Google Earth Engine for planetary scale analysis. I want to show one case study in which we used Earth Engine to detect the boundaries of urban areas in India. And I will show you the whole process of doing image classification in Earth Engine. So India is, of course, a very good case study. because it is one of the largest and most populated countries in the world. Almost a third of its population is urban, and it's expected to reach almost half by 2050. And it is characterized by heterogeneous land cover. And this is very important when you want to evaluate classifiers, because you want to know whether the classifier can be applied on different types of land cover. You want to evaluate the generalization of the classifier. There are different methods for image classification, and we heard some of them today. We applied supervised machine learning, and really generally speaking, the idea of supervised machine learning is to use real labeled examples, which is the ground truth, to learn the characteristics of whatever you want to detect, train a classifier, and apply the classifier on new examples to see whether the classifier will be able to predict the whatever class you want to detect. Now, in urban research, there are different ground truth data that can be used, not so many. Some existing raster and vector databases, for example, WorldPop dataset, and hand-labeled examples, including examples that were labeled by crowdsourced platforms, including OpenStreetMap. So we generated a random stratified sample of 21,000 examples. Each example is 30 by 30 meters. It was proportional, it was distributed throughout the country proportionally to the population size of each state. And for the initial stratification, we used the WorldPop dataset, which, if you don't know, it's a raster dataset where each pixel is 100 by 100 meter with the number of people living in this pixel. So we sampled 40% of our examples in highly populated areas and 60% of the areas throughout the periphery. The examples were labeled either as built up or not built up. And the rule was that if a polygon is covered more than 50% of it is covered by paved areas or any man-made structures, it will be labeled as built up. Otherwise, not built up. As the classifier's inputs, we used Lancet, Lancet 7 and Lancet 8, calibrated scenes. And for each pixel, we calculated per band median annual values of the least cloudy pixels, meaning that we took the stack of all the Lancet images that were taken throughout the year, we removed all the scenes with cloud coverage above 10%, and we calculated for each pixel the median value of the different bands. In addition, we also added per pixel NDVI and NDBI. We heard what is NDVI, it's an index for vegetation. NDBI is another index for built-up areas. So now we have the inputs, and this is Lancet. For each pixel, we have all these features, all the bands, and the calculated indices, NDVI and NDBI. And we have the output, the polygons that we labeled as built up and not built up, using Google Earth as the background. So now what we need to do is to merge these two sources. So now for each pixel, we have all the inputs and the label whether it's built up or not built up. Each of these pixels is a training example. We are using all these training examples to train a classifier and to predict the built-up areas over new examples, in our case, over India. We used three types of classifiers. I don't have the time to get into them, but one of them is CART, which is a decision tree with a binary recursive partitioning. It just asks yes or no throughout the branches. Random forest, which is an ensemble of many trees, and SVM, support vector machines, which is a linear decision function that aims to minimize the margin between the two classes. Now, How do you evaluate a classifier? A good classifier is a classifier that can be generalized on new examples. So as we already heard, we want to partition the data into training examples and into testing. We did a k-fold cross-validation, where the idea is to take all the data and divide the data into, in our case, it was five folds, five groups. In each fold, you maintain a similar proportion of the classes, in this case, built up, not built up, and you evaluate the accuracy rate in each example. In each example, you train the data with all the examples in k minus one folds, and you test it on the remaining fold. In addition, we did a spatial cross-validation. I said that India has a heterogeneous land cover. So what we did, we trained the classifier each time on 13, with all the examples in 13 agrochromatic zones, and tested it on the remaining one. There are different measures for accuracy assessment. The most naive one is the overall accuracy rate, which is just the how many examples were classified correctly. But in many cases, you will not have balanced examples. For example, in our case, we had many more not built up examples than built up. So another measure is the balanced accuracy rate, which is the average between the true positive rate and the true negative rate. We evaluated the different classifiers throughout India, and these are the results of the five-fold cross-validation. You can see that overall, the balanced accuracy rate is around 80%, and random forest with more than 10 trees reach the best performance. The addition of NDVI and NDBI as additional features to the classifier improved the classification, and with the addition of these two indices, the performance of Lancet 7 was similar to Lancet 8. And that's good if we want to monitor urbanization processes, because Lancet 7 was launched in 1999. And we also found that the more examples we feed the classifier with, the better the performance is. But we don't just want to evaluate the classification, we also want to be able to detect built-up areas. So what you see here is the classification result over new areas, over new examples. In this case, this is a pixel, and each pixel is a new example that the classifier tries to predict whether it's built up or not built up. What you see in this map is where the prediction is higher than 50%. If the classifier thinks that a given pixel, the probability of a given pixel to be built up is higher than 50%, it will be classified as built up. So you can see that also in high resolution, the classification looks very good. And we can also apply this classifier to detect the boundaries of urban areas. This is zoom out. You can see the boundaries of different cities in India. But we also want to understand urbanization processes and how cities expand and evolve. And the idea is that if you have a trained classifier that was trained on data, on recent data, in our case, 2015, and you're using the same Lancet image, you can also apply the trained classifier on any given year. So what you see here in this case, you can see the expansion of one city in India between 2000 and 2014. The classifier was trained on, actually on 2015. The classifier was trained in 2015, and the trained classifier was used to detect built-up areas on Lancet, on the Lancet image from 2000. So we are currently working on creating this layer that will map all the built-up areas, we're starting with India, in any given year. So to summarize. Urbanization is one of the most fundamental trends of the past two centuries, and it of course affects many dimensions of the modern world. However, its rate and magnitude have not yet been quantified with sharp precision at global scales, and existing maps generally are limited in their temporal or spatial resolution. However, satellite data are increasingly available, and they allow us to detect built-up areas also in very high resolution and in temporal dimension. With cloud-based computational platforms such as Google Earth Engine, we are now able to monitor urbanization processes also in global scales. Extension to this work, we are now working on improving the classification by modifying the inputs to the classifiers and adding more dimensions, for example, including nighttime light features or socioeconomic variables. We are working on evaluating some of the new high-resolution imagery, whether it's Sentinel-2 or digital globes and worldview data. We want to evaluate the use of OpenStreetMap as ground truth data because this is available in global scales. And of course, we want to also improve unsupervised machine learning and to integrate our data, the ground truth data, to improve the classification results. So thank you, and you can contact.